I'm Lea Chapin. I'm here with Marissa Stoner. Today we are going to talk about her past life connection. Many of you know that I am a psychotherapist. I have a master's degree in counseling, and I've combined my work as a psychotherapist with my ability to hear spirit as a clairaudient, clairvoyant, full sensory medium, psychic. And part of the work that I do is helping people understand their past lives in conjunction with their current life challenges and issues. And today, Marissa has asked for some clarity about why she is such a seeker. And I guess I'll just let you describe in your own words your own sense of like understanding or clarity that you're looking for.
Sure, well, it's probably the clarity. Why am I such a truth seeker and so interested in the stars without really looking at the technical side of it? I don't go deep into it, but I feel there's an affinity, there is something there that's for me, and I just keep going back and back again. And I feel that there's something in the past that it needs more understanding, more clearance for me. So I'm very interested to know, why do I have this passion for the stars, and resonate with them so much?
And before I start my channeling, what I was already sensing, that this was a lifetime in Atlantis where she was an astronomer. So I was already seeing that in my mind's eye, that this past life connects to the Atlantean civilization when she lived in the highest part of that civilization, and she was an astronomer, and she connected to the stars, and she connected to the galactic brothers and sisters, and she had that curiosity then. As now, as she's carrying this over in this lifetime, she still has that remembrance or that feeling or that need, because that's what happens to us from our soul remembrances, is that we're carrying over memories. They could be, just like for her, is this quest or thirst for knowledge. In other cases, we have relationships, we have karmic relationships where we're not able to understand why am I still, I want to say, addicted to this person or obsessed to this person or unable to detach from this person or move on, or why we have certain phobias, why we have addictions, and understanding our characteristics and our personality traits. So today I'm going to bring in the energy for Marissa, and it feels once again that it's Priestess Isis that is stepping forward to share this information with Marissa about her lifetime in Atlantis. So here we go. Greetings, my beloved. Yes, it is I, Isis. As I step forward into your energy field, dear one, I ask you to take a deep inhaling breath and begin to breathe in the energy of love. Begin to relax your mind, begin to relax your body, and allow yourself now, if you can, to begin to return in the stillness of your mind, the quietness and the remembrance of the lifetime in Atlantis when you were an astronomer. You were working, as we say, in the highest part of that civilization when Atlantis was thriving, when the individuals in that lifetime, in that civilization, were living in balance and harmony, and all were united in what we call the energy of the law of one, where all life, including your own life, was deeply connected to all that is. You were part of what we call the scientific community, and you were an astronomer, and you had what we call an advanced telescope, and you were able to observe the stars and the planets, and intuitively and innately, you were able to connect to the other star systems. You had a deep connection to the star constellation, not only of the Pleiades, but also of Sirius, the dog star. And you would look night after night after night to your advanced telescope, and you would view the stars with such curiosity, with such wonder, And yet you were telepathically communicating with both the Syrians and the Palladians. You were not 100% aware that you had this telepathic communication, and yet you would receive inspirations, and you were also literally a scribe, and you would write down what you were sensing or feeling or observing as you were looking through the into the stars each and every night. Of course, at that time, you were a male, for you were part of this team of individuals who were quite advanced, extremely intelligent, and were of curious nature. And yet, that lifetime was extremely rewarding for you because you were living your passion. You were living in this sense of fulfillment that you were able to somehow be able to tap into this energy, even though you were not fully aware of the telepathic communication that you were receiving. You literally had inspirations and you were able to transcribe what you were sensing or seeing or observing and bring it into this scientific realm. In those days, there were many who were quite connected to the Galactic Brothers and Sisters, and yet you were one who was a bit timid or did not feel that you had that level of ability to telepathically communicate with others. In that culture, this was in some ways natural, but for you, you were again of scientific mind and you were a practical mind, and yet your mind was of deep curiosity and of deep intellect. And so you were comfortable with your ability to relate what you were feeling, sensing, or seeing as an astronomer in what you call the scientific realm, and you documented what you had felt or what you had seen. This is a part of the curiosity now, as you are very much curious about how life works or how life ticks or how the universe operates in divine order. For you, you are curious by nature, and it is not for you in this lifetime to have scientific proof. You now are more attuned and tapped into your own spiritual knowledge and your own spiritual communication. Therefore, your inner gnosis, your knowing, is your greatest ability. Claircognizance is your greatest sensory ability, or what you may call your own intuitive senses, your claircognizance, for you know what you know. In that lifetime, you were clairaudient, and yet you somewhat dismissed this, for you were unable to allow yourself to feel the full sensory senses because of your scientific mind. And so Isis is going to pause there. I know that was a lot to digest in some way, but I don't know if any of that made any sense to you. Have any resonance to any of that?
Very much so. Oh, I did feel that warm, fuzzy feeling when you said the cognizance, because I have
the what?
The confidence to say, I know, without having the sight or the hearing. So I'm thinking, I know that. How do I know it? Doesn't matter. I know. So you have definitely confirmed for me that feeling of confidence that I do know and understand. So now I understand. Thank you, Lee.
You're welcome. Were you able to feel this energy of your previous incarnation? Because I could actually see him in my mind's eye.
Yes.
I could see him looking at the stars every night. And then I saw him transcribing, and then, you know, being so passionate. So
yes.
I didn't know if you were able to see anything or have any sense of that.
I did have a sense of him, myself, in that past life, and just enjoying. Couldn't wait to get back into that telescope.
Yeah.
And to sense, feel, you know, write it down. So I was feeling that energy.
Uh-huh.
I felt the very fuzzy warmth of confirmation.
Yeah.
That's beautiful. Thank you, Lee.
You're welcome. Did you have any other questions about that lifetime or anything else you wanted to ask?
Not really. I'm just thinking, apart from the knowledge of the stars in this lifetime, I just feel I want to know the truth seeker.
Mm-hmm.
So just, are they combined? Are they connected?
Mm-hmm.
Because it's not just the stars. Everything,
uh-huh.
any mystery in this planet, I am just, can't wait to open a book or look
right.
research.
Uh-huh.
So a big passion of release all the truth and let's bring it out in the open for the world to know. It's time for us to know where we came from and what we are.
Well, they show me that that strand runs through you, not only in that lifetime, but in this lifetime, and then it's a strand, or I'm going to call it a theme,
mm-hmm.
where that's within your soul, that you, your soul family, you come from the family of truth.
Mm-hmm.
So there are groups, or I call pods, of soul families, and you come from the family of truth.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why you're a truth seeker. So that's why you have your curiosity now and in that lifetime in Atlantis, that strand or that theme or that was prevalent. So he was aware of that.
Mm-hmm.
So you're still carrying that same theme,
mm-hmm.
or that same pattern, or what I call that strand within you. And you've held that through all incarnations of time. Through every incarnation, there's always been that level of searching for truth,
mm-hmm.
and yet it's you've brought it forth through different ways in different lifetimes, and so the strand of it, the core of it's still there, and yet the way that you express it in each lifetime is different, but the essence is still there. Like, I know that I'm from the soul family of giving, and so, but each incarnation you'll serve in a different way, or you'll give in a different way, and so you're from the family of truth, and so with each incarnation you'll be giving in a different, you know, you're serving now, seeking the truth now,
mm-hmm.
in the expression of this incarnation, where other incarnations, okay, I did it a little bit different, but you're coming back, and it's all, I'm just seeing it as just in a circular fashion, where it's like, I guess it's the wheel,
mm-hmm.
the wheel of the cycle of the soul, within our own Akashic records, that it expresses itself in whatever we choose as in our incarnation. And so I want to share with those who are listening that the connection to our past lives and to our current life issues may be a bit foreign to people, and yet I've worked with multitudes of individuals in my individual readings and also in group settings, but in individual readings. Most of my readings, when people call me for readings, there's typically a past life connection that is influencing your current life situation. So if you can allow yourself to be open-minded to that, you don't necessarily have to understand, but if you're going to be willing to receive and open your heart to do the clearing, because a lot of the work I do not only is informational, the spirit will actually come in and do spiritual healings and clearing some people from their past life, so that they're no longer holding that energy imprint, and then they can clear that energy, or spirit will come in and do the clearing,
mm-hmm.
and then they'll come in and they'll bring the healing work and then replace the energy with what you wish to create within your life. So as you release a part of the patterns from the past, then you can bring in the energy of, what do I want to create? Do I want to create happiness? Do I want to create peace? Do I want to create joy within my life?
Mm-hmm.
With, for you, it didn't feel like that lifetime was any sadness. It just felt,
mm-hmm.
like love and curiosity. And yet, maybe as you understand this, you're like, okay, in this incarnation, it's like I'm just seeing,
yes.
for you, maybe what you can say is, show me more.
Yes.
You know, let me open to more. Let me open to more to the truth. Let me be open to more of being a seeker of truth,
mm-hmm.
and holding myself as a vessel or conduit of that. So if that makes any sense, that you're allowing yourself to expand into the greater essence of your, I'm calling it your soul essence.
Mm-hmm.
So hopefully I haven't confused.
No, you haven't. Very much so. It makes so much sense. Because I did wonder why I was heading that way. Like sometimes it was like, okay, I'm thinking I'm going too far with this truth thinking, but now I feel I understand it's in my DNA, my essence, so I can go forth and be feeling so much happier, and which I was anyway, but yes. Well, thank you so much, Lee.
You're welcome.
Very much clearer.
It when I work with people, it resonates within their being, and so when I do these readings, that's why I ask people what they feel or sense, and typically they'll actually feel it within their heart, or they'll have some emotional reaction, or it'll touch them emotionally, so I know that their soul is speaking to them, and that's their truth of what has been brought forward. So I just want to thank everyone for allowing us to have this opportunity to share the work of spirit and what I call spiritual psychotherapy. As a counselor, I knew many, many, many years ago that how I was working as a traditional therapist was limiting, and when spirit brought this beautiful gift for me to be able to share the words of spirit and help people understand their past lives through the clarity that I have by working with spirit, that this was the marriage, this was the work that I was looking for, because I just remember back in the early 80s there was a better way of helping people than I was doing as a traditional psychotherapist. At that time I had no idea what it was. And now this spirit has
beautiful
brought
gift.
This forward.
Beautiful
so
gift, Lee.
It may seem a little unusual, but for those who are open to it and receive it, the many blessings to the soul to have that release and that understanding.
Yeah.
So
thank you
for,
Marissa, thank you
for
so much.
Being brave enough
beautiful.
To allow me to bring this forward for
wasn't
you.
Wasn't hard to be brave. You were a beautiful, sweet soul. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.